if you ask people on the street, what do you associate with design, then they will look at their headphones and say, well, that's a good design or a bad design, something that is tangible.
So design could be this, you know, this person who makes these nice things, you know, chairs or objects, right? And that is design, because that is, of course, change. If you're going to design a new chair, then that's a change, right? It's not a very big change in somebody's life, but at least it is a change, right?
Ensimmäinen asia, mikä musta on saanut, mut on saanut kiinnostumaan muotoilusta, on se niin kuin esteettisyys, kauneus. Se on ollut se graafinen puoli, se on ollut niin kuin julisteet, jotka näyttää nätiltä, tai muotoilu, joka on nättiä. Että on niin kuin esteetikko, mutta hyvin usein sitten niin kuin jotkut esteettiset asiat on ihan äärettömän epäkäytännöllisiä. Ja sitten se risoomoo ihan hirveästi.
Kun maailmaa rupeaa katsoa käytettävyys silmin, niin sit sitä ei voi nähdä enää. Niin kuin, you can't unsee.
Muille ihmisille muotoilu varmaan viittaa just enemmän teolliseen muotoiluun. Mun mielestä se kuulostaa siltä, että suunnitellaan Fiskarsin sakset tai Iittalan kuppi tai joku semmoinen niin kuin konkreettinen asia. Mutta mehän muotoillaan, kun me muotoillaan ei materiaa, me muotoillaan niin kuin kokemuksia ja palveluita, niin se on niin kuin välillä tosi vaikea selittää, että niin kuin mitä me oikeastaan tehdään työksemme.
It's not like a beautiful form that you can see that this is a very nice piece of furniture or something like that. A good service is something that it's transparent, you don't see it, it's invisible, but it creates an experience for you.
If design really has the possibility to have a storyline that takes you to the things that you want to get out of the product or out of the service, and on the way really even is able to surprise you and delightful get you to whatever you want to achieve with it, then the design has succeeded and has a high quality.
Kymmenen vuotta sitten muotoilu oli vielä niin kuin, paljon ehkä suoraviivaisempaa. Et siinä oli niin kuin selkeä sävel, että esimerkiksi nyt tehtiin verkkopalvelua, mutta nyt se voi lähteä jo sieltä bisneksen miettimisestä. Ja et se, niin kuin se muotoilu käsitteenä laajenee ja työtavat ja menetelmät niin kuin muuttuu hurjalla vauhdilla eteenpäin.
In the future, where this should be going, is that there's an impact where what our clients are doing with our products. Whether it's planet-centric design, whether it's just social improvements, things like that, that there is some meaning behind the design work. And that takes us away from return on investment and margins and things like that, looking at the product and design just as a monetary issue, that you, how you can make it cost-effective, for example. That would be something that really brings content into your work, when you can look a bit past the numbers, see this as a stepping stone to make something better.
We kind of continue to design for the buy button. We cannot continue to design for convenience. We can't continue to design for usability. So, you know, what we need, of course they're all good things, but we also need to consider the planet. We need to like design for like a sustainable future. And depending on the scale or the impact of that kind of service, then you start making really big differences, you know. So if you're working with a massive company that has like hundreds of thousands of, you know, millions of customers who use your digital services, that's potentially quite a big change.
Se on se mitä me tänään on tehty esimerkiksi. Muodostetaan yhdessä sitä tavoitetilaa, mitä kohti halutaan mennä, ja yhdessä työskennellään sen eteen.
And I think this is what many of the designers that I know in the company are already doing. What Vincent Culture resembles, which is the empowerment of people. People are grown in that company with quite a high level of confidence and with a low level of fear. So also making mistakes is something that is allowed and welcome and not something that you should be afraid of and try to hide under the carpet. And that's what makes me comfortable and believe that from there we can grow easily and have a way of grading bigger quality in the future.